Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Georgie and in today's video, I'm going to be reviewing this beautiful palette from Pat McGrath. This is the Mothership Mega Celestial Nirvana and this is a really beautiful palette. I just received them this afternoon, so I'm going to film right away so that I can deliver it as soon as possible. If you are planning to get it is a holiday collection, so it's really nice. And if you are wanting a more detailed and swatches of this palette, I'm going to have a separate video for that one, so I'm going to include the link on the description down below if you want to see that. But in today's video, I'm going straight into the application and we are going to see how it performs, the blending, and how it packed. So let's get into the application. I'm going to do two separate looks today so that we can get to know a little bit about the product as well and see how it goes. All right, here we go. I get you guys a little closer so you can see all the details, but I'm very excited with this palette. And I did prep my eyes with the MAC Soft Ochre, this guy right here, the Pro Longwear Paint Pad, and I really wanted to see the shade of blues on this palette, so I'm really gonna have to try that today. And most of the time blues are difficult to blend, so we are going to see how this palette performs. I wanted to dip into this sort of like orangey tone right here as my transition. I'm gonna use my NYX brush number 16 here and see how it goes. This is going to be my first impression, so I definitely gonna let you know how the products pack and how pigmented they are. So there you go, I did not put too much, but right away you can already see the pigment of this product is going to be awesome. And I just love when a palette performs that way because you don't have to worry. So far that is the first dip that I did and it looks good. This is almost like a pink one on my skin, but on the palette it almost looked like red with a little bit of peachy peeking through, but on my skin it just looks like more pinkier. All right, first blending, I'm going to dip in just a little bit more to get the color, and I think that's everything that I need. So it's a very nice shade so far that I first dip and it's not getting patchy. I think the prepping of the eyes helps a lot. Now I'm excited for the blue ones. I'm going to be using a different brush from that. This one is from Sigma number E33. So E33, and I'm going to dip into this dark blue right here on the very top. Right there. It's such a big palette that I kind of like having a hard time showing you guys. So I hope if I don't show the color, that's fine as well. But this is the deep blue I'm gonna put right outside my crease. Okay, that is so far not bad as well. This is going to be a dramatic look today because I really wanted to see how this deeper color and brighter color packed and blends. Okay, so that is the first initial touch and a little bit of blending, but so far very nice. Okay, so that blue one definitely needs to blend a little bit more because of the way how it is packing on my skin. You can see a little bit of patchiness, but it's still pretty manageable. Alright, so that is the blue and I'm gonna pack just one more time to deepen this right there. Next color, I wanted to put this like really bright blue in my middle crease so that I can see how it looks like. Okay, so grabbing this blue one with my Sigma E25 and try to see how this one looks like. This is a shimmer color. Ooh. Okay, so I'm very careful with this one. Wow, you see that guys? It's a very nice bright blue color, and mixing it on the first transition color that I applied, it has this very nice transition of purpley blue, which is very interesting. I really like that. I'm just gonna bring this a little higher because I don't have a crease as usual, so we have to bring it higher. So I'm bringing it all the way to my inner corner of the eyes, as you can see right there. Okay, so that is the blue. So far, I really, really love that really bright blue, but now I feel like I need to build up with the very first shade that I did, so which is this one here. I'm just going to blend it and so you guys can see. Alright, so far, that is our first look. I'm just gonna try to blend this one here, and that's it. So the first look there. So now, let me go into this eye. I definitely wanted to try the purple tones on this one, so let me grab just a fresh brush. This one is from NYX again. I have two of this brush, number 16. I'm gonna grab this like really light pink here and make this as my transition. We want to see how bright this one goes and just kind of apply it for higher. Okay, so that's definitely a good transition shade because it feels like it doesn't loosen any color once you blend it. Some other colors, once you start blending it in your skin, it just disappear, and this one seemed to have a lot more pigment in it. I'm going to go with this like sort of purpley here. Just wanted to see that. So this one is interesting. I feel like this is a little more less pigmented, but it's definitely buildable. Let me just give this more chance to build up. Let me change my brush. Maybe it's the brush. That one was synthetic. Now I'm using a natural hair. This one is from NARS, number 44. Okay, so that blends a little better and also picks up product better as well. And now, picking up this slightly lighter shade, still a purple one, and try to just kind of put it here in the middle. So far, what I find on this color, particularly the purple ones, are needing a little bit more attention with the blending. Okay, so that's starting to look more alive, I would say. Now I'm picking up a metallic shade here, and I don't know what to use, but I'm probably gonna grab this super nice gold color here. I'm going to use my finger to just feel this product and put it right there, and I'm just gonna blend this a little bit. Don't worry, because I'm gonna mix this with a different shade. I just really wanted to try that and maybe soften it a little bit. And now I'm gonna pick up this sort of pink color here. This is, ooh, that's so pretty. This is how it looks like here. And I'm gonna pack this in the front. Oh wow, I really love that shade. That is such a beautiful one, actually. I might just kind of put this all over. I'm gonna put this on top of the gold ones because I feel like that's such a pretty color. That's a very interesting combination. So I put the gold under and put this really soft pinky purpley metallic on top, and now it's giving me this like earthy kind of like light and bright color. You can see I wanted to apply more shades of this palette on the bottom of my eye, so I started putting this sort of dark maroon color here and just wanted to build up a little bit more so that we can see more of the color. And now I'm gonna pick up the shade blue to get this darker. Wow, so that blue one, the moment I put it under my eye, it's just crazy. It's just gone like from level 8 and then all the way to level 20 because that's just how it is. It's every time you put an eye color under your eye, it just adds more drama. It's not as, you know, bright blue, but it's more of an indigo or navy blue. I'm going to add that first shade that I did earlier so that we can get transition. Alright you guys, that is the complete look for this eye. As you notice, the difference with eyeshadow under your eyes and without over here is just making my eyes a little bit more rounder and dramatic. Let's move into this sort of color of purples, but I really wanted to try this green color. I wanted to go crazy on this palette and let's try it. I don't know what's gonna happen, but I'm pretty curious, so let's add this here. Why not? I'm going to add a lighter pink, the very first color that we make as a transition on this side. Ooh, I really, really like that. So now I'm just gonna cover my eyes so that you guys can see the difference. So if you take a look at there, you could definitely see that green one peeking through. I really, really like it, right? And then I'm gonna look down. You guys can see the detail. That metallic shade is just perfect. And then I'm gonna move here. And now I'm gonna show you on this side as well. As you can see, I really like that addition color on the bottom. Look down here. There. One more glance and it's just a beautiful dramatic look. But here is my final thought and kind of initial thought about the palette. When I first swatched it, definitely the matte finishes are harder to swatch. It's kind of a little patchy, so I was worried about that. But once I applied it, I did not have a lot of difficulties when blending the mattes. Definitely some of the purple ones are a little harder and you need to pay more attention with how you blend and how you actually pick up the product. Definitely consider the brush that you're using, and easier when you're using a natural hairbrush. Synthetic ones are fine, but it seems to not pick up product well and it doesn't blend well, so consider a natural hair. But overall, the look and the pigmentation, all the color, I'm very impressed. It's not as hard as I thought when I first touched the product. Some metallics here are impressive, just like this blue one. It did really pop. If you want a pop of color on your eyes, it's a beautiful one. If you don't have something like this, it's definitely the ones that you should consider. And I also like that this palette is half matte and half metallic and shimmers, and that is something that I really consider right away because a lot of her launches are more metallics and I really wanted to have a palette that has a matte finish, and this one just did it. So here it is one more time. There are some browns that are impressive, so make sure to keep an eye. Maybe I wanted to upload another one, but let me know in the comments section down below. Also, if you wanted to see the swatch again, I have mentioned it earlier in the beginning. I will include the link on the description down below so that you guys can see all the swatches and more details about this palette. Overall, I really like it, and the packaging and everything, it's such a good palette to have. So if you don't have this one yet, make sure that you grab because it's beautiful. I really like it, and I really think that it's worth your money. You get a lot of shades, you get a lot of metallic, really, really good combination. So that's it from me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy this and you find it useful. Please give it a big thumbs up if you did. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Make sure that you hit the notification bell so that you are updated whenever I upload my next video. I have a lot more coming, so make sure to watch out. And yeah, that's it. Thank you guys, and I will see you on my next one. Bye.